You mentioned DHT, dihydrotestosterone. Is that a potent male erectile hormone?
So dihydrotestosterone is the sort of testosterone that really gives erections. So the higher the levels of dihydrotestosterone are, the more a man has orgasm, ejaculation. So for ejaculation, you absolutely need to have this hormone. Men also cannot ejaculate if they have, but then really in even a more serious way, they cannot ejaculate if they don't have oxytocin. So the men who don't smile, don't want to see people, are autistic, they can, even if they have long-term sex or long-standing sex, they cannot ejaculate. And when they receive oxytocin, they can ejaculate much easier.
Hmm. So if you were to look at a patient who's starting to respond favorably, oftentimes they may not need Viagra. However, they could be low in nitric oxide. So there's certain plant-based foods that contribute nitric oxide. Certain supplements help. So do you look at, in addition to abstaining from, as you mentioned, alcohol and some of the issues that cause problems, do you look at any supplements that help with estrogen dominance? Some of the men are exposing breast tissue, and what's going on with that? How are they getting this estrogen dominance?
Well, basically, you're giving two sorts of information. One of the sorts of information is that if men have too much female hormones, it will
yes.
block the action, and you need to take plant extracts or progesterone or blockers like called aromatase blockers, because they block the enzyme that converts testosterone into estradiol.
Right.
So all these products may really help sexuality too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really interesting to go into that. It's not sufficient on its own to have a fantastic sexuality, but at least you decrease the risk of having the other treatments not work by improving that. And the other information in, I forgot actually about the other point that you were saying.
That's good.
Let me see, I don't know. So we talked about too much estrogens, and then you were talking about something else that you would, nitric oxide.
Yes.
So now they are also coming on the market, some precursors to nitric oxide, mm-hmm. like arginine and others, that by taking that may also help erection. So the nitric oxide is a substance that opens up the arteries, and so you get more blood flow inside of the penis. And that might be also interesting in some men to supplement those nitric oxide precursors for having good erections. And if some physicians, some patients prefer not to work with hormones first, they can have a try with all these precursors of nitric oxide.
Dr. Hertoghe, all this talk about sex, is there a component that relates to some of the longest lived people in published studies that they had an early interest and proclivity to sex and they maintained a longer, better quality life?
There's a centenarian study that showed mm-hmm. that those who became centenarians are more liberal on their sexuality, and that means that they have more liberal views, they may have, and they usually are more often married, meaning that they have sex easier, they don't live on their own. So probably they are also richer in sex hormones, these future centenarians, and it's better to be so. One study showed, for example, that women who are centenarians have 2.5 times the testosterone level, the male hormone, the one that gives the most libido, than women of 70 years here in the United States.
It was
in Japan, in Okinawa.
Yeah.
Those centenarians have 2.5 times the woman the level of male hormone.
They also had higher DHEA and higher estrogen levels than the equivalent 70-year-old compared to the 100-year-old.
Well, the DHEA level of a centenary woman in Okinawa is the same as a woman of 70 years old, but and even slightly less, but it's at age 70, it's much higher.
Wow.
So when they are age 70, those who have high DHEA levels will probably live up to 100 years.
In Okinawa, they have more of a plant-based. They eat a lot of purple yams and sweet potatoes and kind of a minimal amount of fish. So it's interesting that here's a plant-based culture, but they don't eat wheat. They're eating mostly yam. Is there probably some benefit of choosing the right plant-based proteins for those who are
yeah,
vegetarian?
Yeah, you have to be very careful because a lot of plants have hormones too,
yeah,
but they're not so much male hormone-like hormones, but female hormone-likes.
Okay.
So if you want, for example, a woman is tired, she doesn't want her man to be able to have sex in the evening, well, she just has to give the liter of soy milk to him, or a liter of soy yogurt, and he won't have any erections, or it will be very hard anyway. So most of the plants that have hormones are actually phytoestrogens, and they will block the capacity of having good sex. For example, when you look at Asian people who live in Asia,
mm-hmm.
they usually have less sexual characteristics. The breasts are smaller, mm-hmm. less body hair growth, but that's not necessarily due to the race, because when they come over in our countries, the next generations generally get taller, bigger, more sexual characteristics. It's due to the food that they have there. There's a lot of food neutralizing our hormones and decreasing our hormone production. If you take 1 liter of soy milk a day, for example, you'll have a decrease by about 30 to 40% of the sex hormones. And it also blocks the receptor, so there's a sort of double neutralization. So I would be very careful for that. You don't forget that also in Okinawa, the main plate is not a vegetarian plate. The main plate is pork meat. And mm-hmm. But they eat pork meat boiled in water for hours, so it's not cooked and grilled and become toxic. Mm-hmm. And the more meat you eat, the higher your sex hormones can be.
There was one published study that showed that beta estradiol was nearly 10,000 times higher in meat. I don't know. Is it because they're infusing hormones to fatten the cattle, and then it's affecting the individuals, particularly men? They don't need beta estradiol. They said it was 10,000 times higher than xenoestrogens or exposures from toxic.
Are you sure that that information is correct? Because the information I had is that it were the plant estrogens on incredibly high amounts in about that sort of amount. And mm-hmm. so I wonder if it was the beta estradiol or the phytoestrogen or the flavones, isoflavones.
Right.
And basically, those are extremely high in plant food, mm-hmm. and they can also come in meat food. So I would be interested in this study because normally mm-hmm. high meat diet increases the
androgens.
Sex hormone levels.
Yeah. Dr. Thierry Hertoghe, how do they get in touch with you? How can they get your material? And is there a current book? I love your book on hormone solutions and your textbook for physicians. But you have a medical school now, and you're training physicians.
Yeah, I'm training physicians. I think it's important that patients get to have physicians nearby, and that they will encourage their medical doctor to go on the to go and train on the website. So my website is called the Hertoghe Medical School.eu, and they can get this information. They on video. We have something around the 50 full days of lectures. There's more possibilities: half days, quarter of days, etc. But where you get a lot of lectures on all the different hormone therapies in a practical way, so physicians can help their patients. I have written also books like the Hormone Handbook, that is for physician, that is really the international bestseller, that explains everything.
Great textbook. Yeah.
On hormone therapy, also how to solve problems when they come in. We have a lot of patients buying mm-hmm. them because they want to know it themselves, mm-hmm. because their physician is not eager or open to learn all that. But so I think patients, they have to become their own doctor and be very knowledgeable. So that helps. And there's many other books that are going to come out, very big books on how to reverse physical aging, how to reverse mental aging, and keys to longevity, but big books, but where you get everything you need to know about how to do it.
Hertoghe Medical School.eu.
Yeah.
So Hertoghe, Hertoghe?
Hertoghe, yes.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Dr. Thierry Hertoghe.
Thank you, Nick.